Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Gamescom. We are here live from the ESL studios, and we are about to kick off Group C here of the second major of the year. Anders, Fnatic, iBUYPOWER, and we just found out what map it was going to be on, too.
Please, Cobblestone, or can we just call it Cobble, because it obviously is. That is absolutely insane. I did not expect that, and even more crazy, virtus.pro and that team randomed onto Overpass, so we're going to see both the new maps today, and that's really exciting.
I have a theory, because we know the Valve devs are here. We know, you know, they've been working on the servers and all that jazz, right? We saw Inferno, we saw Mirage, we saw Cash. But I think by the time the third group rolled around, they kind of got tired of that, and they were like, wait a second, guys. We can actually control everything here. Random third maps. Overpass is in one match. Cobble is in the other. I think Volvo are involved, man. I think something's afoot.
So Cash has recently added to the competitive map pool. We see one new map and two and three. It's almost confirming Half-Life 3. Is that the next step? I wouldn't be surprised. All right, we'll investigate later. We'll see if we can figure this out.
But we happen to be in Germany, so we know we're well-equipped here to be able to get some information out of them.
Oh, yes, we have the tools. Now, look, I mean, this is insane, especially this map, because this is the mother of all sniper maps, and we have JW, who is definitely a capable sniper. We have Skadoodle, who is absolutely insane.
I'm more worried about Skadoodle, man. Like, what he does with the AWP is unholy. Like, it should not be allowed, basically. He's on the fast track to hell. So this, I mean, Cobble with Skadoodle and the AWP, it's hard to top that. I think JW, he's got to be sweating right now a little bit. You know, he's got to be a little nervous, a little worried.
And have mercy on our souls, because this is the first time we're going to be actually casting, not playing, because we have put in a lot of time, not always fun time trying to figure out these maps, but I don't know. I actually think between the two, Overpass is the slightly superior map in my opinion. I think Cobblestone suffers from some more deep issues, and mostly with the B-bomb site, in my opinion. That's what I'm looking forward to the absolute least, because the B-bomb site is so intricate. It's so elaborate. There are so many spots that calling out who's where is going to be a nightmare beyond belief.
It's going to be really interesting. I mean, hell, you know, you got porta potties on the map, too.
Yeah, that's a huge upside. Well, the toilets are definitely a big plus.
You get bogged down taking a site. You need to take a breather. Wear better, right?
Yes.
Cobble, you know, they thought of everything. The devs, that's up, it's happening.
Yeah, and we will do our very best to avoid any jokes that we can. We can't promise anything at all, because
we're not full of anything here at ESL.
No. Exactly. So look, guys, big thanks for tuning in. Of course, we are going to, it's going to be a best of one game here. Group D is where C is where we're at. Not D yet. Group D is the group of tears.
Is the group of tears. That's what we've named it. It's going to be a very sad group.
Almost certainly cry when we get to group D, no matter what happens. There is no good outcome in that group at all.
No, I think a lot of hearts are going to be broken when we get into that group. You have three amazing teams in Group D, but right now we are in Group C. Same story, though. I mean, you still have VP, Fnatic, iBUYPOWER, and that team. And that team right now are currently sticking it to VP as well on Overpass. So this group, I mean, Group C and D, it's a fantastic way to end the day. But as you guys can see here, we have the brackets. Currently being played right now is also VP and that team on Overpass. So we have both new maps that have been put into the groups. We have them right here happening at the same time.
And what we're doing today is we're doing the first one of the two games here, then we're doing the lower bracket match, and then tomorrow we pick up on all the groups from the winners and the following match. So we're going to do half the group stage today, half the group stage tomorrow, and then, you know, Saturday and Sunday we're going to pick it up with the playoffs. And for once in an actual tournament, we get to do all the quarterfinals, the semifinals. So this event is going to be slowly ramping up, and it's going to get better and better. But now, look, guys, we are headed into the game. It's going to be on Cobble for a best of one between iBUYPOWER and Fnatic. So welcome to ESL 1 Cologne 2014, the third major in the Counter-Strike saga so far. And if you have any friends out there who are not already into Counter-Strike, now is the time to convert them. Ready and waiting here is Fnatic on the CT side, and it's going to be the American iBUYPOWER team on the counter-terror side.
Let's get into it now. This is going to be it. On the counter-terror side, Fnatic got the first pick in the map ban, so they will get the first pick as far as the side. That's how they end up on the CT side here, but we already see the layout here for Fnatic. Four guys towards that B site, just ready to lock it down, and they're dropping in everywhere. Pronex and JW double-teaming them, getting two, but they do get overwhelmed in the end.
Yeah, it's still not really a favorable trade for iBUYPOWER. They're in a 2-on-3, moving into the speed. Bombsite Crims is here. He's going to go down, actually. Olofmeister will pick up the second kill as a third one. Olofmeister shutting down iBUYPOWER in that bombsite. It could have maybe worked out, But Fnatic have, I think, a good grasp of how to defend. And this is what we were talking about earlier. In a way, it's all theory crafting, because we haven't actually seen a competitive team play. We've been playing matchmaking, but it's not a good basis for comparisons. But it seems quite obvious that the weak spot here, if you don't allocate enough players, is the B bomb side. If you lose control of B and mid at the same time, you're in a lot of trouble. A, maybe a little bit easier to hold with a single person, because you can spot people coming from such a long distance away, and you can call for backup. So simple, you know, theory crafting going on here.
We already see, great shot there from Swag, and that's the kind of shots that we need to see out of him. Everybody's going to be looking for a strong performance from Swag, but he already starts off strong, picks up one, gets caught when he tries to put that Bison to use. For shame, Swag, for shame. That's what happens to you. It happened to Pronax. It's only natural it happens to you, too. Steel going to get chased back up into A apartments, though. Or rather, this is B apartments. We're in connector right now, but, or is that A? No, that is B. This may happen a little bit because, you know, like you said, man, we actually haven't had any demos or anything at all to go off of. None of the pro teams have played this. We haven't been able to see it anywhere in recent time, right? So getting any kind of information as to what these teams are going to be up to has been very difficult. So this is it. First match, totally fresh, and we get to all enjoy it together, basically.
Yeah, definitely, and maybe, yeah, we can all learn something together here. So this place right here, people have been coming up with all different kind of names for this one. It could be, you know, the drop-off, it could be whatever. Someone came up with the name Skyfall, which I think is a reasonable name.
Skyfall's pretty cool, actually. Yeah. But, you know, it's like, I think Vent, like we were calling a drop room, basically. It's like, you got drop room, and then you got B-Main. And then...
I like the James Bond reference.
Yeah, Skyfall is actually pretty cool. But, I mean, then again, well... you could also say, you know, it's like it's raining men, right? The song, you know, they're dropping out of the sky.
Yeah. I'm all for that. All right. Well, look, third round coming up now, and iBUYPOWER will have rifles for the first time, having lost the pistol round. They have actually not put down the bomb yet, and still they go for rifles here. So that's actually a bit of a stretch. I thought definitely with Skadoodle on the team that they were going to try and go for an AWP.
Yeah, they're going for it just because they had such successful first rounds. I mean, first and second round, it was all so close. They got a lot of frags from it, and this is going to allow iBUYPOWER to put some pressure on. And there you go. Steel starts off strong, picks off Pronax, wall banging. And now Fnatic, they're down a man on the defense, and we can already see the reaction here. They've rotated Flusha over from that A site towards this B site to help plug the gap.
Yeah, and over at A long, the long way around towards the hallways there, they're actually putting JW kind of aggressively. I'm wondering if he's going to keep pushing if time goes by. Right now, he's just standing still. And Krim's defending with another smoke here. They still have a Molotov as well on JW, so we'll see how it all unfolds. Still 50 seconds left for iBUYPOWER to make another opening if they can.
Yeah, they still have some options here. One smoke going to go ahead and block off B entrance here. As we see, Olafmeister now just going to try and flash. But still, I like what iBUYPOWER are doing. They've sent two guys over to the A side of things, one in mid, one up in A apps, to try and draw Fnatic out. And JW is going to get rewarded for his patience. He picks up one, and that's a big kill from him.
Yeah, and that's a really big problem. They needed to get that kill on JW over at the... Oh, sorry, not on JW. Yeah, on JW over at the A bomb site, because now... The split push they were doing doesn't really quite work out the way they expected. Twag pushing up the middle, but look at all the angles he has to cover here. Looking for the kill, turns around. Great shot on Flusher. Goes for JW, gonna pick him off as well. Great round from Swag so far. Now a one on two, and Swag, oh my god, picks up a triple kill with absolutely stunning precision. And iBUYPOWER win the third round. That was truly something.
That's Swag. That's what we were waiting for. The bird is flying, and this is it. I mean, those shots were just insane. Swag, I mean, if Swag is hitting his shots, iBUYPOWER, they are a force of nature. There is no stopping them. They're going to come out of the sky, pick you up, fly off, and devour you. Skadoodle has now picked up he's got a scout too now, which is a scoped weapon. Thought it was an op for a second there until I got a better view of the model. But still, iBUYPOWER now turning it around, putting Fnatic back on their heels. They are on pistol right now, Fnatic, and they're going aggro as well, really trying to get a jump on iBUYPOWER.
Yeah, JW hiding in the corner here, but Steel and Dazed are picking up some important kills right now. Good shot from JW with the CSET 75. We'll pick up a second one and go back for a little bit more, but doesn't seem like it's gonna be too effective here, as iBUYPOWER have sort of stabilized the situation, just holding tight, waiting for a Fnatic to keep repeating.
Yeah, they just need to play patient at this point, JW. They have the opportunity to do a bit more damage here, but iBUYPOWER seem to have figured things out. They've already sent a man over to that A site. That is Swag on a mission. He's already going to be in position to be able to catch a man rotating over as well. If Flusher decides to walk through here, he could be in for a bit of a surprise. And this should be another round here for iBUYPOWER as they have control of this site. Now Flusher trying to peek around, being sneaky, hoping to be able to catch somebody off guard, but that is not going to be the case. iBUYPOWER are in position, and Swag finds the headshot instantly.
And Swag is I mean, you already said it, but I think I just want to reiterate for anyone watching here is probably the main difference for iBUYPOWER, not just in this game, but in this whole tournament, because at Gfinity, iBUYPOWER actually did pretty well for themselves, and that was in spite of the fact that Swag almost did not show up in a lot of the matches,
yep.
which is a huge contrast to how he's been playing in online things, and that is what happens to a lot of players. You got to remember as well, Swag is probably one of the youngest players in the whole tournament. He's 17, so going to a LAN and playing, and especially a major like this, it is really tough. So I wouldn't be surprised if he's going to be suffering, but right now, he's been doing really well for himself, and if he plays well, iBUYPOWER is a really hard team to play against.
It's a force to be reckoned with. I mean, Skadoodle as well, we saw just sick plays from him at G3. Like, he had a sick performance. So if Swag can come in and compliment Skadoodle, it could get out of control completely for Fnatic here. Now, Fnatic, fifth round here, they have ecoed, so they are going to be able to get a buy going. Flusha will go with the scout, so he'll have a little bit of firepower going over to that A site. But this is going to be a crucial round now for Fnatic to stop iBUYPOWER. They need to be able to just shut iBUYPOWER down and take their money away, essentially. Force iBUYPOWER either to force up with rifles or go back to pistols, so that Fnatic can get a bit of breathing room here and just get some control back. Flusha looking towards mid, and this is pretty much what he has to do. This is such a wide open space. It's so difficult for the T side to block any of this off with smokes. And so he's just going to take advantage of that. Plenty of angles to look towards, but more importantly, iBUYPOWER, they aren't going to manage to sneak their way in there with Flusha holding.
Yeah, but you can actually tell the way ACK was peeking that he definitely knew that angle existed. So that's good news. I mean, it means iBUYPOWER have done a little bit of homework on this map, and they've obviously let it through as Fnatic, so maybe that's a bit of a sign as well that they have actually been putting some effort into it. This is, well, actually not looking like much of a push at all, because they have the bomb dropped all the way back here, but they are going into it. What are they doing with the bomb back there? I have no idea. Pronax is going to get picked off here. It's a great headshot, and could have been a second one. Flusha almost caught out. He's going to re-peek against Dazed with just a pistol. Scout in hand, and he picks up the kill, but they lose Crims in the meantime, and they're still falling. So now it's a 3-on-3. The bomb finally picked up towards that B bomb site. This seems like it's going to be a fake, but now they are taking it back. We can see on the minimap. And if it ends up being an A push, then JW is going to be a bit of a lurker in this bomb site. And that could be tricky, because if Flush is going to be up here in the apartment that's right next to the CT spawn, then maybe he's going to be drawing enough attention for them to forget about JW.
Exactly. He's a real threat with that AK as well. If he can find some headshots here, this would be huge to just slow iBUYPOWER down. But if he can draw their attention, and that's exactly what he needs to be doing here, JW is still alive on that site, and he runs right into him. Skadoodle with an easy kill. 7 seconds left, and the bomb will get planted. And Flusha now in a very tough position. He gets one, though. Brings it back to a 2-on-2. But he needs to win versus AZK, and he's not quite finding the shot.
Oh, and it's going to be Swag alone, 1-on-2, he gets the one kill. Now Olofmeister's so low on health, Swag has a good advantage here, and Olofmeister is going to go down. It's Swag again to clutch it in a 1-on-1 like that, and iBUYPOWER bringing it back in style right now. It's going to be 3-2, and it's going to be Fnatic back on ecoing, and I think in spite of JW, who actually has 7-0-3, so he's been doing a really good job, I think he mixed up the order there, because basically the plan seemed simple enough, right? You draw their attention and I rush out.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, at some point, JW just thought, wait a minute, what was the order? Am I going to rush out and then, you know?
And then you draw the attention, like, how's this? But what was admirable there from iBUYPOWER's play is that they actually checked the site. You saw all three of them actually running all the way to the back of the site there. So they weren't going to leave it up to chance. They were going to make sure that there were no lurkers to catch them in the back if they tried to go for the plant. So you got to admire iBUYPOWER and their play right now. They are being very thorough, not really giving any opportunity to Fnatic to pull any kind of sucker shots there. But Fnatic, once again, back to pistol. That last round was crucial for them as far as the money is concerned. They have yet to get a strong economy going for themselves, and this from a team that really does need the rifles here to set up a strong defense.
Crims with an interesting position, and this is the first time we see iBUYPOWER actually going straight in through the main entrance at B, trying to see if they can take it straight on. And there is a bit of a stack going on here. Good opening shot onto Pronax. Still three members left in this bomb site, and iBUYPOWER inching their way forward here. Olofmeister is maybe going to pick up a free kill, but I don't think it's going to be quite enough. He moves up, C-set 75 in hand. It could have been a great double kill. And now coming in, JW is going to run right into Swag, and he doesn't win the duel. So that's going to be 4-2 now, moving into the seventh round. And I mean, it's hard because the only data we have on this map is going all the way back to Counter-Strike 1.6, where people did actually play Cobble competitively.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was a hugely counter-terror-sided map, but it's been changed a lot. This is not the 1.6 Cobble. It's actually pretty far removed from it. So mm-hmm. I don't know what to say, but similar. Well,
the other thing is, I mean, it is quite fresh, right? We're still seeing, you know, teams figuring it out. But one thing to note here is that Fnatic has now picked up an AWP. It was Olofmeister who dropped it for JW. So they do have the sniper rifle. Now we get to see exactly where they're going to put it to use. Funny thing is that Skadoodle, he thought the same thing.
He wanted to have fun with the crossfires as well, man.
Yeah. And JW is all the way over at Long, like he's been playing the whole time, so they seem to be holding some steady positions, and I'm not sure about having the AWP here. I would much rather cover the B-bomb site with the AWP and then leave a bunch of people in the middle. That would be definitely my preferred setup. JW goes down, in fact, Swag up close with a good headshot.
Yeah, Swag looking so solid. Pronax waiting, lurking, hoping somebody's going to go running past. Not sure if he heard Daze there, but Daze, the last time that they faced, Daze got the best of him. We'll have to see if that happens again. Good smoke to block it off, though. Daze is going to force him out into the open, and Pronax looking for the opportunity, but he eats the flash and doesn't see anything. iBUYPOWER have yet to commit, however, but they do have all five members alive. So when it comes down to it, there's so much power right now, so much firepower on their side, and Daze finds Pronax yet again.
iBUYPOWER really slow playing this. Olofmeister gets the one, but it's not enough. They need more. Krims has to come up huge, and he's not gonna get it. Swag takes him down. Krims instant headshotted, and now Flusher should not really be taking this fight. He should be running away and saving the rifle. He's in a 1-on-4, and even though they are low on health, this B-bomb site is really just not retakeable as one person. Not even close.
So many angles to check, and yeah, Flusher will back off now, but you got iBUYPOWER, watching that round, it was almost as if we were watching an anti-eco round from them. Do you notice how every single time they were just two, three guns waiting, picking them off, Flusha, Fnatic, one at a time. There was no safe place to go for them. Every single time they turned a corner or iBUYPOWER pushed out, they're pushing with one, two, three. So iBUYPOWER should pick up another round here. Flusha point blank picks up Dazed, and that was with Skadoodle's AWP as well. There will be no save here. As far as iBUYPOWER are concerned, they will not get to keep that sniper rifle, and Flush is going to make damn sure of it.
I think he actually rammed him with the AWP, which is not really how you're supposed to use a sniper rifle, but if it worked, all right. Pronax, disturbing, he has not picked up any kills yet. He's actually at 0, 4, and 7, which is definitely pretty far from ideal, and Krims could step it up some as well, but right now, it actually feels to me like the way iBUYPOWER are playing is they're inching their way forward, and then when Fnatic get a little bit too curious, they step in and see if anyone's there, and iBUYPOWER ready to get the kills. It's a smart way of playing, and Fnatic probably needs to realize this eventually and just start playing slightly differently. In the window room, JW in that middle area is looking at Skadoodle. He's aware that someone could definitely come from it, but look at the amount of angles Skadoodle has to cover here, and JW has a lot fewer angles to cover, so he should have the advantage in this position.
Especially since JW will always get there before the T side, right? So he can set up, he can make sure that Skadoodle is going to be under pressure. JW playing it very safe in fact, not really going anywhere with it. He decides to kind of just sit back, change up the angle a little bit, fall back a little bit to that A site. In the meantime, iBUYPOWER still floating around the B site yet again. This is going to be the main point of contention on this map at all times practically. This is the way into B site, but it's such a strong choke point that iBUYPOWER, they basically have to come through here if they want to put pressure on Fnatic, and Fnatic know it. They've got four guys sitting on this B site right now.
Steel moved up to a really forward position. I don't think they're going to expect him. So if they come back to peak, just like in previous rounds, if Fnatic's not getting curious and wondering what's happening here, they could easily lose a member. And Pronax, oh sorry, Steel is going to go down there. Olofmeister picks up the kill, and that's really good. Pronax waiting in the connector is going to go down after trading the one with Dazed, and then we're into a 3-on-3, and it's going to be a push for the A bomb site. JW actually sandwiched in here, and he's going to be really careful. Otherwise, he's going to get shot in the back. He turns around, misses this kill, and now he's down to 67 points of health. Doesn't get the no scope. They're right around the corner, and ACK from inside the bomb site will take him down, and he's going to be alone. 1-on-2. ACK goes down, and a great triple from Olofmeister will seal the deal. Fnatic will win the round and make it all the way to 5-3 here.
And they get the off as well for all. That is a big save, actually. Do they decide to actually hold it to hand it off to Flusha, though? No, Flusha will hand it back to JW. Bit of a mistake there in the end with the drop. Flusha has the money to be able to drop as well. And we do have a pretty reasonable buy coming out here. Problem for iBUYPOWER is because they had to actually rebuy that AWP, we've seen that their economy is taking quite a hit. They're falling a little bit low now, so the pressure is going to start mounting here on the T side. I mean, they've got five rounds already on their T side, which is impressive. But they definitely want to get more against a team of Fnatic's caliber.
Yeah, I mean, I expect this is a CT-sided map, but at this point, we really don't know enough about it to make a proper judgment. So you guys out on the stream, you're going to have to learn with us, basically. I'm still going to call it a CT-sided map, but they could prove us wrong at this point. That's definitely a big possibility that will happen. Right now, a bit of a split coming up here as iBUYPOWER once again drop the bomb. They're looking for pickoffs. They're not looking to take a bomb site just yet. And Pronax is defending the Skyfall.
Defending Skyfall right now. Pronax continues to wait. Dazed, he's looking towards that position, though. Pronax maybe get a little bit... I mean, it's not a question of being predictable. I mean, it just... Pronax is going to hold this spot, and that's going to be it. That's the end-all, be-all, because Pronax decided it was that way.
Ex- Exactly. And it's a good spot that he's holding as well, because if they throw in flashbangs, he can very easily just go and look into the corner of the wall and he shouldn't be flashed at all. But they're just going to jump down clean. He does get the first pick off here. ACK will return, almost goes down, and they pick off Crims as well. Now Olaf Meister has to stay alive at all costs here. He's going to make a jump for it. Swag running out of the smoke here and still not going down. It's actually into a 2-on-2, but the time here is a big factor. 25 seconds. Swag in a 1-on-2 has to get the kill, pick up the bomb, or just get both kills, and neither is going to be very easy.
No, and Olaf Meister is playing this so well. Just taking his time. That flash gives away his position, but that 10 seconds left. There's just not a lot of time here for Swag to act. He's trying to sneak his way over to that site, maybe get into position, be able to drop this bomb. He's got 7 seconds left, and he can't get onto this bomb site in time. He's out in the open, and they are not going to let him plant. He gets one kill, but Flush is there to save the day for Fnatic. One man alive at the end for the Swedes, but they get the round on the board.
That they do, and it does cost them a lot, but it also forces iBUYPOWER to eco. So that was a really, really nice play from Fnatic at the end. Looked a little bit scary if Swag could have, if they had been further away and he could have put the bomb down behind the fountain. Actually, I think in that situation as a terrorist, you have a pretty good chance of taking it in 1-on-2 because of the distance between you and the CTs, but doesn't work out that way. And Fnatic don't really have a lot of armor. And look at actually iBUYPOWER, they forced it up anyway. What?
That pressure. Oh man, and the nades raining in. It's a bombardment, and Dazed is down to half HP, and that's not good. He's the man who's got the armor and the AK as well. He's trying to put it to work against Pronax right now, but Pronax manages to sneak his way out of there. Krim's going for the wallbang, not really having an effect. Didn't really see it do too much damage.
And they're trying to return some as well. They're going to smoke it off to try and prevent anyone from coming in here, and iBUYPOWER are just waiting. They really want somebody to take some
sort of
peek.
Are they
going
to go as three? It seems like they're just going to try and drop together or peek together again. iBUYPOWER, you really just working well together, taking the peaks at the same time. Good flash though from Pronax, gets one, can't get the second, but still, they've done so much damage to iBUYPOWER at this point that Fnatic, they should be able to clean this up without even losing a man.
It is an interesting idea, stacking four people up there. It's almost like a lemming type strategy, just all rushing in, but it doesn't work out this time. They only had the one AK and they all get shut down. But they might actually be able to buy next round as well because they've lost a lot of rounds in a row. So I think maybe that's the reason they did try and force it up here. They will still be able to buy, what, four AKs and one Galil? Yeah. Wouldn't even be surprised if they go for it. No AWP picked up. They could have gone for a no armor AWP, but they are going to choose not to do that. So
Dazed is the one to take the hit. He goes straight P250 for full nades. So if he actually went for a rifle there, it would have just been a Galil in armor. Instead, he opts to go for a full buy as far as the nades are concerned, and he can just pick up an AK if one of his teammates goes down. So this isn't a bad play from Dazed. They just want to set it up. And they are actually going four guys towards that A opening right now, out in mid. This is going to put some pressure on the A defense here for nearly the first time.
I think this setup from Fnatic is really dangerous. Yeah, Flusher falling back, I think, is a really good idea. I think you can't, as much as it looks cool having two people over there, and it's a nice idea having JW with the Max 7 close, I think if you put two people over there, the rest of the map is going to be too weak. I don't think you can afford it, but we'll see. They did fall back eventually, and now I think they're in much better positions on the Fnatic side.
Exactly. I mean, Steel is making noise over B-Apps right now. He's trying to make it sound like there's a whole troop of people here. Krim spots him out. So they're keeping three guys on the defense here, and eventually iBUYPOWER decide to move back towards this B site. So yet again, very slow play from the American or North American team at least. 45 seconds does not leave them a whole lot of time. They're going to start feeling the pressure now. They need to actually go in. And the smokes are going to go down now, so this is going to be the beginning here. Do they actually manage to pick up some frags?
Olaf Meister still over in that corner. He's going to go down Steel with the opening pick, and now the rush is on. They got to go for it here. 25 seconds left, and they got to get in and get the bomb down quick. Everyone from Fnatic has shown up. A really quick rotation from the Swedish team. ACK is actually going to be taking down Crims. Pronax will drop Steel, and now the bomb is dropped here. 15 seconds left. It's a 3-on-1 now. Pronax, the only one left, but he can still win. Just denying the bomb. They got to find him quick here, and Pronax turns around at the wrong time. Going to go down to Swag, but that was a dangerously close round. Just 6 seconds left. If they hadn't killed him right there, if Pronax had ran away, they could have lost the round anyway. 6-5, and moving into the 12th round, and Fnatic, they can force it up, but if they lose this next round, things are going to go from bad to much worse.
Yeah, this is going to get out of control, and iBUYPOWER now enough money to go for a very full, healthy buy here. Fnatic forcing it up, just 3-4 guys. Well, I mean, Olafmeister, he's only got one smoke. The rest of them have decent nades, except for JW, so this is really Fnatic having to play it patient again. iBUYPOWER. Whoa, Swag is all the way up there in the tower. That's a first.
Swag is confirmed to be that one guy in the public server that you have to go and find at the end of the game that's hiding in the sniper tower. That was the bane of 1.6 Cobble, was finding the last terrorist. That was always one guy there. And that's Swag in this case.
Well, Swag, you should feel bad. I mean, how many frags is he up to now, Swag, as well?
He has been doing really well for himself. 17-0-5.
Yeah, that's okay. Not too shabby. All right, but right now, man advantage for Fnatic. So Fnatic, they get to take their time. They get to play this patiently. And again, Fnatic, just going back to very standard hold as far as they're concerned. Three guys holding over a B, making sure that that one point of entry can't be abused by iBUYPOWER.
Okay.
Dazed with a sick headshot onto JW, though.
Yeah, it's impressive because there are so many angles you have to check when you do that, you know, rotating peek around. I mean, if you miss it for a second, he almost did. He's down to 10 HP. That was pretty good. Now, Pronax is the one defending here, and he's got Flusher with him at the back of the site. So Fnatic actually have a really good setup to deal with this, especially because the guy in Connector is really close by. Krims is in the middle of the map, just ready and waiting. Skadoodle is going to go down, and Pronax takes almost no damage for it. 20 seconds left here. iBUYPOWER not leaving themselves much time to do anything at all. Smoke is up here, but Pronax will pick up a second kill. And Krims with a smart rotation. This is not going to work out for iBUYPOWER. Swag alone in a 1-on-4. He's going to pick up the one kill here and has to die, actually, before this runs out. So there it is. He goes down. Triple from Pronax. Nicely done. And that, you know, he was at 0 kills earlier, so it's good to see him stepping it up right now.
Yeah, a bit of a rough start for him, but he's got, now he's actually even 10-5-10 from Pronax. So the in-game leader for Fnatic, he's starting to throw his weight around. iBUYPOWER, however.
I mean, so because we have Vendetta here as the observer, we were talking to him a little bit about how it all worked out in 1.6 on this map. And actually, he was saying is if you got three rounds on the terror side in 1.6 of this map, you were super happy. That was a lot. So six rounds, I don't think it's entirely, you can't really transfer the whole thing, but six rounds might not be too bad for iBUYPOWER at this point in time.
Well, this should be advantage CT, and Olafmeister's going to get flashback around this corner, and so it begins. iBUYPOWER just going for the rush. But this is a pistol round coming out from iBUYPOWER, just trying to eco, and Olafmeister keeping his cool, managing to set up the crossfire with Krims at least. He gets taken out eventually, but not before getting two kills. Swag gets caught. So, but I think you're right. I mean, it's still, you can still tell it's a little shaky on the CT side, but it's also iBUYPOWER just playing this very patiently at this point, really not trying to push anything. There it is. That's what I was wondering, if they were going to get the AWP for Skadoodle.
It's a good pick. It's a good idea, I think. Still none on the CT side here, but they've done all right with the rifle, so I don't really blame them for keeping that up. I'm still surprised that they haven't gone for the guy in the back of the B-bomb site with the AWP on the CT side. I wouldn't be surprised. I predict iBUYPOWER are going to do that. That seems to me like a logical thing to do, but we'll see. It's a great pick off, not with the AWP, but with ACK's AK-47, takes down Flusher. And that definitely opens up, especially because they got this kill so early in the round.
And Skadoodle is currently looking for the man who's going to be waiting around the corner here, JW. Good flash. But JW has got, he got himself up in the, at the top of the ladder now, so this is going to be nigh impossible to get him out of here, but at the same time, he's kind of stuck. If iBUYPOWER managed to push past through mid, and JW is up here, it's not exactly an easy thing to get out of here.
No, it really isn't.
I don't know, can you jump out the windows?
You can't.
So you're doomed. You have to go down that stairwell.
I think you do need a teammate maybe to help you down, basically, to flash you in or anything like that. iBUYPOWER, 45 seconds left here, and they're moving towards the bomb site where three people are holding. So Fnatic have a really good idea about what's happening right now. This could really easily help them win the round. Krim's down here, waiting for anyone to jump down, and Dazed might be the guy.
Yeah, smoking off Pronax's likely hiding spot. Krims, however, should adjust. Nice nade there to deal 20 damage. Dazed is still kind of dancing, though, but 25 seconds left. This is not a lot of time here. Olafmeister, Krims, Olafmeister, they're just, well, slaughtering them. And iBUYPOWER running right into a near-perfect hold for Fnatic, only losing Krims in the end.
So what was really smart about that round, actually, is the way they dealt with Krims. Unfortunately, they didn't count on Olafmeister picking up a sick triple kill and putting himself at 19 in total, by the way, which is just one short of Swag. But what they did is they had one guy jumping through the Skyfall, and they had one guy actually running out the main entrance to B and backstabbing Krims. So they were sort of pinching him in, and they had already smoked off the other spot, so they only had to check that one. That's a very cool idea. I like what iBUYPOWER did there. But now we're in the 15th round, and they really don't have a lot of anything. They have pistols to clean it up with here, so we could be seeing a 9-6 finish, and who knows if that's enough. Dazed goes down.
Highly likely now, right? I mean, pistols again, Pronax holding fairly aggressive, actually. If he manages to get the peek on somebody, this could be big. But a great nade right there onto Swag and AZK. Going to drop them fairly low. That was courtesy of Crims. Pronax finds the headshot on Swag, and the defense here is going to be just too solid for Fnatic. iBUYPOWER have to just land some insane shots if they want to manage it until Pronax dunks them with a perfect AG onto AZ. K, that is.
Second grenade coming in, doing quite a lot of damage. So 9-6 seems like inevitable at this point. Skadoodle and Steel are left here, and it's not going to work out. All of Meister have been holding this spot just really well. Crims with the last kill of the round, 9-6 for the first half in favor of Fnatic, which is actually impressive if you consider what a shaky start they had. So it seemed like at some point they decided, actually, we're going to stop losing rounds and just step
actually,
it up.
Actually, we're going to stop peeking. We're going to stop, you know, trying to get into these duels. We're going to slow everything down. We're not going to give iBUYPOWER any freebies. Nope. And Fnatic actually just locked it down at the end. And that's, you know, it could be just Pronax. I mean, Pronax, he's a small guy, but he can be scary, right? Strong voice.
And considering he started off at zero kills, like five rounds into the game or something, and now he's at 12, is definitely not bad. So well done.
12 with seven assists.
Yeah, well done, Pronax, for getting back into the game like that. It's really important, of course. Skadoodle on the other team with only two kills is a huge surprise. I thought this would be his kind of map with the AWP, but maybe we are, you know, overplaying how much of a role the AWP is going to have on this map, because Fnatic did all of this mostly with rifles.
Exactly. Pretty much no AWP at all put in use.
JW every once in a while, but not really many kills with it.
You know, that's the thing. We never really saw the AWP have any kind of big impact. It really seemed like Fnatic wanted to rely on the nades and the rifles to do the work for them. You know, get up close, hold aggressive positions, or at least aggressive angles, right, where they would be able to pounce on iBUYPOWER if ever the opportunity showed itself. As far as they're concerned right now, though, Fnatic, do you think, I mean, do you think after seeing this now, do you think that nine rounds is enough for them to get into it?
I doubt it, but I mean
it's all speculation from here.
Yeah, it's all gut feeling at this point. We don't have any data to fall back on. If we have to dig up something to go on here, we have to go all the way back to Counter-Strike 1.6, where people played this map, and there was even an attempt of a remake called Forge at one point. And there it was, you know, it was definitely a very CT-sided map where six rounds would have been, as we heard from it there, you would have been celebrating. You would already have claimed your victory just asking the other team to leave the server because you already won. That's the kind of victory it would have been. But now we have no idea. Second half is coming up, ladies and gentlemen. So big welcome if you're just joining us. I think we have 173,000 people watching, which is stunning. You guys are amazing. So welcome here to the ESL One Cologne 2014. The third major in the Counter-Strike series that we're seeing right here.
This is it.
And we're at Group C at this point in time. Yep. The first match of that group.
Just past that halfway mark here. This is the first match of Group C as well. And so, Fnatic and iBUYPOWER. Fnatic now swap over to the T side. JW leading the charge here. Just trying to get in. Well, trying to get into position fairly quickly here, but the nades are going to go out. iBUYPOWER just setting it up, but Fnatic going full YOLO. They're just dropping down. And surprise, AZK is taken out immediately.
It's a very nice kill. Now they drop on Skadoodle, and he's actually going to go a kill, which is pretty impressive. Thought he was going to go down. Flush, a time to reload. It's going to take down Dazed, and now all the way at the back of the site, there is Steel holding with very little HP, and in the other side, it's Swag. So they've zoned out the CT forces here, and the Fnatic, they're hunting as a group right now, which is looking really effective. Steel will pick up one kill, but they're all coming for him. And how many can he kill before they get too close for comfort? The answer is just the one. So now Swag, one on three. Long range with the USPS is great, but they also have three USPs, so I'm not sure this is really going to work out.
He needs to find an instant headshot, pretty much, and Pronax has just got fancy feet. He's dancing too well. Swag can't keep up. Olafmeister will put him down. And that is the pistol round picked up for Fnatic. Both pistols, in fact, picked up for Fnatic right now in this map. So this is a very strong performance when it comes to these crucial rounds. The Swedes really locking him down. iBUYPOWER now going to be on the back foot here going into it, but that doesn't stop them from buying three scouts. So it seems like Anders,
no, but
iBUYPOWER are all about, you know, they're like, oh, we didn't see a nearly enough scope to play in that first half, guys. Okay, let's go ahead and give them three.
To me, this seems like a really logical choice. The scout has been reduced in cost, so, you know, you can afford it like this. I'm not even opposed to this right now because of the range. Again, look at the range here that's going on. Skadoodle down towards the middle of the map, looking up all the way to the terrace side, basically, of where they start.
And look at the setup here from Steel with the B on B site. And rather than putting three guys solid on that B site, they have Steel with a scout jumping at the back of the site.
And this was roughly my prediction, except I said it was going to be an AWP, but I said leave one guy here and then have the rest in middle or A. And I actually want them to put even more focus on the middle than they are right now. I think this is leaving the mid really weak at the moment.
Let's see here, Fnatic. They've grouped up in B. It's going to come down to Steel. Does he have the right timing here? AZK gets flashed. Gonna be looking for a different angle to work. He's gonna catch one off guard, and that's JW managing to get picked off. The start flush that gets one to the face as well. And that's not gonna help things here for the Swedes. AZK goes back for more, but Pronax will finally put an end to him, but not before taking 60 damage. Skadoodle getting caught, and this is just raining it in. Pronax, 3 kills.
Swag rating right here. 5-7 in hand is not going to pick up the kill, and that sort of seals the deal. Pronax, triple kill, and Steel is going to save the scout. And, I mean, we managed to talk about it basically 5 seconds before it happened. That was exactly my point. The weak, the middle of the map, too weak. They should have had, I would have said they should have had one scout in A, one scout in B, and then 3 people in the middle with pistols to hold that down. Mm-hmm. And then count on the scouts to make it work. I think what they did was actually not very smart.
No, well, I mean, when it comes down to it, it's all down to positioning, and it's also all down to shots landed there. AZK managing to do some damage in that round, but the rest of his teammates just kind of getting caught completely off guard, shot in the back in some cases by Pronax, who's just vicious. He has no mercy.
Flush has already seen Steel, and they really want to take, at least Flusher wants to take this away, but maybe he's being called back. Yeah, I think he's been told, don't do it, it's not worth it. So Steel will save the scout at least. Not really a big victory, but we'll see. There's still some rounds left to play with here for iBUYPOWER. Too early to say how this is going to unfold, but Fnatic obviously 5 rounds away from taking a victory here, which is good news.
Well, this is looking like Fnatic are in a great position. JW will be just going for the pistol here in this round. Does he have the AWP or is he just sticking to CZ? It seems like he does have the CZ. Not enough money for him to get that sniper rifle quite yet. Whereas on iBUYPOWER's side, as expected, pistols across the board for them, apart from Steel, who did manage to hold on to that scout. So Swag is going to get up here fairly aggressively, just going for shots, and he doesn't hit a one. Olafmeister will punish Steel as he's going for the shot onto Pronax, and
that's unfortunately the scout lost as well. And are they going to... I was wondering who was going to grenade the scout
back. Yeah,
it actually
does
fall back. I'm not sure if that was really the intention, but either way, it works. It's making it more difficult for anyone from iBUYPOWER to pick it back up again, but they're not even going to play that game. They're just going to go and put the bomb down to the A-bomb side, and that's the goal anyway, so why not just go straight for it?
They smoke off connector as well, so it really gets tough here for iBUYPOWER to rotate in. They're going to get funneled into one tight spot, and this is going to be AZK. I mean, there's a bit of a crouch spot, much like Mirage, where you're able to go through the wall here from CPL to CT, right? Same sort of thing,
yeah.
But it's not... doesn't seem like iBUYPOWER are interested in taking part. They're going to go the long way, try and wrap around, and hope to catch him off guard, but Olafmeister, he's already here making sure that flank can't happen. iBUYPOWER actually getting very little done here in their follow-up rounds, not inflicting a lot of damage to Fnatic's economy.
No, definitely not. ACK Close would like to pick up some sort of exit frag here, and maybe he's going to be able to. He's not quite quick enough, actually, and Crims is going to easily take him down. Dazed has occupied the sniper nest all the way towards the terror side of the map, the terror spawn. So here it is, going to be into the 19th round. 12-6 is the scoreline. So doubling the round, the number of rounds that the iBUYPOWER have is Fnatic. I'm wondering what rifles they're going to pick up. They really can't actually even afford an AWP. So it's going to be the Scout and then M4s all around.
Mm-hmm. Limited nades as well, not that many to fall back on. Whereas Fnatic, as we can see, just plenty to go off of right here. Now we have to see if Skadoodle can wake up, basically. Give us that G3 performance, because Swag has definitely stepped up his game. If Skadoodle manages to start landing some shots, we have a real fight on our hands here. iBUYPOWER could stop the train. And Dazed setting up the crossfire, going with the spray. Steel is going to take damage, but Dazed gets a kill.
And Steel very low on health here. Crims is going to take down Steel right afterwards, and Dazed will pick up a second one. And it's going to be Swag helping out. Headshot onto Crims. Now they're actually going to go for the fight, Fnatic. They're not fighting to put the bomb down. They're fighting to even the odds and then try and do it. So this is interesting. Leaving Pronax close and JW trying to see if he can get back to the site, but it's not even that easy right now.
No, he needs to find the proper angle here, but the smokes are about to clear. AZK is going to be able to look through, and he will find it. Skadoodle, in fact, will find the frag on JW. Pronax waiting around the corner, manages to get one, but Swag will end him. And that is now that 19th round, that crucial 19th round, one for iBUYPOWER. They hold on to 3 guns as well, so this is good for them. Fnatic still plenty of money to buy, though. They will be able to get one more full buy-in here, as we can see. Still a little bit of, actually quite a bit of money left over on 3 guys. So they still have options here, Fnatic. It's not done yet, but iBUYPOWER at least, they buy themselves a chance.
And what is interesting now is whether or not this AWP from JW can do what Skadoodle didn't do on the first half, which is go and get pickoffs. If you can pick off one or two members with the AWP, it's definitely worth it. Skadoodle does have one, and he's covering exactly where JW is covering, so they're not going for the B setup that I keep recommending. But they probably know better than I do, so we'll see if the rifle setup at B is going to work just as well as it actually did for Fnatic.
Well, that's the thing. As soon as Fnatic stopped going for like aggressive peaks or aggressive plays, iBUYPOWER they kind of faltered here. So we have to see if iBUYPOWER are going to be able to give Fnatic a bit of a taste of their own medicine. Krim's trying to take point. AZK is going to catch him, though. Just perpetually flashed everybody as they try and drop through Skyfall. And Pronax is currently waiting to see if he can catch AZK, who's playing in his own spot right here. Pronax, he's not going to have any of this.
Skadoodle did go down all the way over at the A hallways, which is really unfortunate. Another flashbang goes in. JW takes down Swag, and now things are looking much worse here. ACK with an incredibly important pick off there onto Pronax. A nice movement from JW straight up the ladder just to check that bomb site quickly. Picks up an M4 instead, and now it is a 3-on-3 with 35 seconds left. And iBUYPOWER need to relax here. They have one guy inside the bomb site and one guy holding from the mid connector. And they should be all right if they keep this up. JW sneaking in here.
And he's going to get the perfect timing to take out AZK as well. Dazed at live at the back of the site, but only for so long. Doesn't manage to get the double kill. Flusha will take him. Drops him down to 9 HP, but now it's a situation for Steel. 1v2, he knows Flusha is low. He just has to figure out where JW is holding from. This all comes down to the hunt for JW.
This is so difficult for Steel. This is a really tight spot. There's so many angles to check. You can see he's doing his best to try and look everywhere all at once, but it's not really easy, is it? And that bomb is ticking away, putting a timer on it. JW actually revealing himself, and he's still going to get the kill. That's a triple for JW and another round for Fnatic. And that was almost a must-win round. Now iBUYPOWER are going to have basically one more chance to do this. And if they fail it, that's going to be the end. And I actually think they slightly brought that on themselves. I think they were way too jumpy in that round. And they forced it up in this one, and I don't agree with this at all. I think this is a big mistake.
They are spending quite a bit of money. Skadoodle going for a scout, Dazed going for a scout. This is, I mean, it's $1,700 now to buy the scout, but still, I think perhaps it's because they realize they're not going to be able to have the money for an AWP in the next round, regardless if they save or not. But it's still a risk taken here by iBUYPOWER. We're going to have to see if it pays off in the end. They need to find the angles to work. There's no AWP on Fnatic, so at least they have that going for them, iBUYPOWER. They realize, well, okay, we're dealing with 4 or 5 rifles. Is this an option to be able to land some headshots? They've spread out quite a bit on the map as well.
We shall see. Steel waiting all the way in the back here with a CSET 75. They are going to be jumping down straight away. ACK takes the peek, almost drops one player, and he's going to have time to reload. Again, they only have two members in the middle here, and I don't think it's quite enough for Olofmeister. Is going to pick up the one kill here, and one of them is even a scout, which is, this is not the range you want to use the scout on at all. So I'm still a little bit disappointed in that part of the setup. Bomb is down, though.
This is huge. He's dropped the bomb. That is a huge kill. Now Fnatic have to come to him. 38 seconds left. He's going to get overwhelmed.
Flusher with a really good flank coming in here, and he spots both players, and he's taking his time. This is really, really smart play. Takes the one, AK in hand, takes down the second one, and Flusher celebrating a little bit at the end. That was really, really good timing. 14-7, and now iBUYPOWER, because they forced it up, they're in a weird position. They will be able to combine some sort of buy here, but I'm pretty sure without the scout, they would have had that AWP.
Skadoodle, 2,400 left on him, and he needs to go for something. Also, that was just, you know, that was like hashtag just flush of things, right? That moment there. I thought for a second when he took the knife out for the second guy that he was actually going to try and knife him that quick. But I was like, no, not even you, Flusha. Not even you can do that. All right, Skadoodle with the scout again. Looking towards mid. Oh, spots one man and puts the shot into the wall. So that's not going to cut it. They need to get one frag. And Swag is waiting up here with the Swag 7.
Yeah, I don't think that last force-up wasn't quite good enough, but Swag will pick up the kill on JWs. That's good news. Now, can he fall back in time here? Actually, they are allowing back a little bit. I think it'd be great if they start playing very defensively right now. No more peeking, just play it safe and wait for Fnatic to come, because you do have the advantage at this point.
You have that man advantage, you need to play off of it. They've run out of nades, though. They're down to 3 flashes here on iBUYPOWER's side. Pronax is going to walk out, not manage to pick up Dazed. Dazed is not going to live for long, though. Olofmeister gets the flank on him. But he's going to be running into another player here towards that A site. He, look up. There, he finds Skadoodle. And that is the A site open, iBUYPOWER. The defense crumbles.
Almost a bit of team damage coming in there. The bomb does go down just in the last second. Olofmeister could have actually been killed. That would have been a massive kill for Swag if he had managed that. Steel coming up here, already being spotted by Flusher, and this is a weird position. He's alone in a 1-on-3, and it's going to be match and map point for Fnatic. And
Fnatic, I mean, there is one, terrific, though.
There is one glaring issue every single round for iBUYPOWER, and it's the middle of the map. They give up that middle part of the map every single time, way too easily.
It's also coming down to Fnatic. Just, I mean, iBUYPOWER, the thing is that they're really not getting the confidence going because they're constantly having to mess around with their money. They're not having the weapons that they want. Swag finds a kill, but that from there, they're not able to push it, not able to push the issue, and limited on nades as well. I mean, really, iBUYPOWER, they're just trying to do the best they can right now with very limited resources. Fnatic doing a terrific job of just keeping them under pressure. Flusha will be taking point here up towards A mid, manages to rush through, takes a little bit of fire. But still, they need to find Swag, and they are going to get him. He's going to have to fall back to the site fairly quickly here. Fnatic are one round away.
Just a single round here. iBUYPOWER not really been doing well at all in this second half. It's been a lot more missed than it has hits. In the corner, Swag is holding with a fight with a FAMAS, not really the ideal weapon, but maybe he can pick up a quick kill and get some help inside the bot. But help is gone. Skadoodle gets killed with JW. It's AWP, and now the push is on for the A bomb site. Dazed is going to fall. Swag gets the one kill. Still 16 bullets left here around the corner. Flush is going to fall. Great job from Swag. Can he do a little bit more?
Oh, he has the perfect opportunity. Pronax looks away from him, gives another frag to Swag, and now it's JW with the AWP. Not going to find the angle there quite yet. 37 seconds left on this clock, though. He still has time to go for the plays. He loads the... Oh, this nade with the flip! JW!
Steel changing his position. Actually, while JW was flashing, that's pretty smart. Almost a little bit of a magic trick there. Steel jumps, misses the shot. He's going to do it again. This is dangerous. One AK bullet is not quite going to kill him, but it's going to, unless it's a headshot, but it's going to leave him very low on health. JW runs for the bomb, and Steel has to move quick here. 9 seconds, 8 seconds, and JW wins the game right there. Quad kill as well, 16-7 in favor of Fnatic, and Olofmeister top fragging at 29 kills. Yeah. So there it is, our first game on Cobblestone.
Our first game on Cobblestone. We've done it. Or more like Fnatic and iBUYPOWER have done it. But that was a very fine display there from Fnatic in particular. I mean, it looked very rocky there. It seemed like iBUYPOWER were doing everything right in the first half, just getting those entry frags, managing to really rock Fnatic off balance. But as soon as Fnatic recovered, Olofmeister nearly dropping a 30 bomb. Like, that is basically Olofmeister getting control back in that first half and just carrying it there into the second, into that T side where everything seemed to work for Fnatic in the end.
Yeah, and I think, unfortunately, iBUYPOWER never identified that mid area of the map. They never understood they won six rounds at least just pushing down the middle. Mm-hmm. And once they got, even if they traded, it doesn't even matter. Once you trade in the middle, you lose all control. There's nothing you can do anymore, almost. It's so hard. So I think that was the main problem, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. But, you know, again, we can't really fault them. They haven't had a lot of time to practice, and that's what it comes down to. That's going to be our first match of Group C.
Yeah, well, very well done there by Fnatic. That is it. So they move on till tomorrow. iBUYPOWER will get to see them again in just a few moments' time, seeing as how we're going to take a short break. But when we come back, it is going to be the loser match here of Group C. One team, it's going to be over, and one team will be going on tomorrow to play in the consolidation match. So don't miss it. We'll be back in 5 minutes.